In this video, we will find out the center of mass of a hollow cone. So this is a hollow cone, and this half apex angle is theta, this length is h, and the element which I will consider on the hollow cone will be a ring whose this width, vertical width, is dy, and slant width will be dy sec theta. I will tell you how. So let us draw a right angle triangle. You can see that. Now this is this triangle which I am highlighting here. This one. So this is dy, and this angle is theta. So this will be dy sec theta. Okay. So this slant length will be dy sec theta, and the area dA of the elemental ring will be length into thus width. Now the length of the ring will be 2 pi r, and width will be slant width, obviously, because ring will have its surface on the slant surface of the cone. So the slant width of the ring will be dy sec theta. Now the value of sec theta is equal to from this triangle you can see that the sec theta is equal to hypotenuse upon base. Now the hypotenuse will be h. In fact, hypotenuse will be under root of h square plus r square upon the base will be equal to h. So this is the value of sec theta, and the value of r will again be calculated by the similarity of the triangles, that from this triangle, this one, we can see that h, capital H upon capital R, is equal to this y upon small r. So small r will be equal to y capital R by h. So dA, the area, elemental area of this disc ring, will be equal to 2 pi r. R is y r by h into dy into sec theta is under root of h square plus r square divided by h. So dA will be equal to 2 pi y r dy under root h square plus r square divided by h square. Now dm will be equal to dA into mass per unit area. Now this is a hollow cone with no base. There is no base. It is hollow from the bottom also. So there is only this surface of the cone, and it has no base. So the mass is uniformly distributed on the slant area of the cone, and the slant area of the cone is pi r l, where l is the slant height. So this is the slant height. Now dA is 2 pi y dy into r upon h square into under root of h square plus r square multiply by m upon pi r into slant height is under root of h square plus r square. Now cancelling this and cancelling pi with pi and r with r, so dm will be equal to 2y dy m, 2y dy m upon h square. Now the y com will be equal to integration y dm upon integration dm. So y com will be equal to integration y dm is 2y dy into m divided by h square and m, cancelling this m with m. So it is equal to 2 by h square into y cube by 3. The integration of y square dy will be y cube by 3, and the limit of y will be 0 to h. So this will be equal to 2 by 3 into h. So the height of the center of mass from the base COM, from the base, will be equal to h minus 2h by 3, which is h by 3. So this is the center of mass of the hollow cone. Thank you.